Sir Arthur Dane?
The Sword of the Morning.
Father said he was the best swordsman he ever saw.
Lord Stark.
I looked for you on the Trident.
And we weren't there.
Your friend, the usurper, would lie beneath the ground if we had been.
The Mad King is dead. Rhaegar lies beneath the ground. Why weren't you there to protect your prince?
Our prince wanted us here.
Where's my sister?
I wish you good fortune in the wars to come. And now it begins.
Hello guys, and welcome back to another video. So, continuing the bleed formation lineup videos, today I'm going to talk about a kind of free-to-play commander which is really useful in combination with other commanders as well in your way to get the bleed formation for your infantry lineups. So Barret is one of the commanders that was added a very very long time ago in the recruitment pass, and he's available there as well, but nowadays you can get his tokens from the Wyvern shop as well. And honestly, Barret is one of the best infantry commanders for starting the game, even if you're not going for the bleed lineup as a focus. So Barret is going to give you stone production, infantry health and infantry defense, and you're gonna say, but how this commander is going to give you only passive stats like defense and health, and he's also really good in fighting. So before we get into that, I think Barret is one of the most interesting commanders in the story, since he's not exactly a Game of Thrones commander that we know of the books or the shows. So Barret Bloodbeard was the leader of a band of sellswords. He had no sense of honor and only desired gold, glory and fresh blood. He was only ecstatic when he was engaged in combat, as he had no interest in peace and was only interested during to turning a profit. On the battlefield he could both earn gold and bathe in the blood of his enemies. He only felt satisfied after slaughtering his adversaries and pocketing their gold. But this satisfaction would only be short-lived. Before long, he would once again continue tirelessly down the road of lancery and greed. So, his story is really nice, really well-developed for any commander in the game that doesn't have any base in the Game of Thrones series or the books. So, continuing back in Barret, let's go and talk about his guard skill and get eventually in the Awakening tree to talk about his potential here. So Barret is going to be really good in rebel leaders, especially fighting spearmen rebel leaders. I'm going to put on the screen on the top left here a fight that I had with a rebel leader yesterday, and his damage output was really nice. So his skills, his guard skills are going to be focused around group DPS and single target buff. So every time you use Barret, you're gonna get these buffs in the PvE department. So Barret reveals his blood curdling streams into the battle, and he's going to deal 11,000 damage to targets in a straight line, and lowers or healing effects on this target specifically. This is really good, especially if you're running against a healing enemy in training grounds. His second ability, a bloody knife, leaves a wound that will not heal, and attacks have 25% of causing bleed, which deals 1300 damage every second for 6 seconds, and is going to stack up to 3 times. Barret is going to add almost 4000 attack and 170 to strategy for 5 seconds every 5 attacks, and he gets 1 attack per second, so this is going to keep stacking. And lastly, he's going to attack to add almost 3.7 attack to all your commanders. So are you going to see here the name of the game is attack, attack, and attack, and maybe some damage dealing as well. He's really good, especially versus spearmen and spearmen formations on the rebel leaders, the wyvern memories, and on training grounds as well. So on his 4-star, his max awakening, he's going to give you 18% infantry defense, 18% infantry health, 80% infantry attack. So 18% of all infantry stats and some stone protection, but I guess you're not really here for that. Starting on the 1st star, he's going to get an increase in active army skill and commander level. His 2nd star is going to give you quality evolution on the friendship, a reduction on his active army skill, and another 5 levels in his max level. 3rd star is going to be the classic 1.6 time of the original value of the passive skill, which is going to boost your infantry stats here even further. It's gonna go up to 48% for infantry health and infantry defense, and 106% for the iron protection. More damage on the active army skill, and another 5 levels in the max commander level. But as always, getting a commander to 4-star is going to be the biggest boost in the commander itself. So first of all, it's going to bring the active army skill even further down by 3 seconds, going down exactly to 15 seconds, and it's gonna go up to another 5 levels to up to a maximum of 80 levels as in every commander. But as we said, the 4-star ability is where the true power of the commander comes out. So Wrath of the Troops is going to be Barret's active 4-star ability. Whenever allied lineup in front row uses 8 normal attacks, there is a 50% chance of inflicting bleed, but Barret will be silent for the entire battle. As always, the bleed formation suffers from the silence debuff, which is a way of the game to balance the damage output of the commanders. So bleed is going to be damage equal to 20% of the troops attack every second for 5 seconds, so it's going to be 5 times 20% of troops attack into the enemy lineups. So as I said, Barret is going to be one of the commanders that you want to use to start your bleed damage, especially from the earlier stages of the game, since it's really easy to get Barret and max him up to 4 stars. Obviously Barret is gonna go hand in hand with other bleed commanders like Senara, since her 4-star ability is going to trigger more and more normal attacks with her fearless advancement. And of course, if you get your weapon as well, it's gonna get a bigger and bigger boost each time. Other commanders worth mentioning, of course, is going to be Rhea with her 4-star ability. She's going to inflict bleed as well, and her 4-star ability is gonna be tied again to normal attacks, just like Barret. So Barret is going to be one of the commanders to look for if you want to start your bleed formation lineup, and you want to start like Chip, since you can get him completely for free, and he only uses elite general tokens in order to awaken him, and he's not using epic tokens. So let's head to the tavern really quick, talk about Barret at the tavern, and conclude this video. So regarding Barret, he is a free-to-play commander, He's going to give you command and combat rate, and pretty good, both of them. They're gonna start on base 3 for both command and combat rate, and go up to 4 each after you upgrade him over the two stars awakening. So command is going to be the free troops, and the combat rate is going to give you the total stats that are comparable to the enemy's combat rate, since combat rate is a buff that's only going to apply if you have higher home combat rate than your enemy. So Barret's going to require wine. There are not a lot of commanders that require wine that are really good, so that is going to help you get him to higher levels easier, since you're gonna have a little bit of wine lying around in your inventory. To finalize, Barret is going to be an excellent commander for your bleed setup, especially in the earlier stages of the game, and he's going to be really strong to boost your infantry stats again for really cheap, since he's a free to play commander now. So I think that pretty much covers Barret. Sadly, he doesn't have any weapons in the game. I hope he's gonna get a weapon soon, since I think he's really useful in every player's arsenal. So thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you on the next one.